Wontonmeen.
Hi everyone, and welcome to another concert here in Wontonmeen in Sham Shui Po in Hong Kong. A tiny galaxy concert which is presented by the Hong Kong Sinfonietta. A new series we've started here in this great space, in this, well, I suppose you could call it a very local, cool and eclectic and mixed area of Hong Kong. Today we're basically featuring one composer, Mendelssohn. And when you think of Mendelssohn, well, at least if you compare him to other composers born within a year or two of him, people like Chopin, Schumann, and Liszt, these are all composers you associate very, very strongly with the piano. Mendelssohn maybe a little less so, but he wrote an amazing series of works over, well, his entire life since he was very young, for the piano and also for the organ, but perhaps his most famous are the Songs Without Words. A series of, well, there's many, I think there's about 8 books and several in each book. Works which are perhaps more intimate than a lot of the more virtuosic and bravura style works which you get in Liszt, for example, or works which can sit very well in a concert hall by Chopin and Schumann. These works are perhaps a little bit more intimate, a little bit more, how shall I say, domestic, and they were probably initially played or premiered literally in people's homes. So I think, well, I should also make clear, I'm not about to play it. We're very lucky that Colleen Lee is going to be taking this seat shortly. When Colleen was thinking about maybe what to play here, obviously using an upright piano, not a full-length Steinway or Fazioli or whatever she normally uses, she thought, well, maybe these works suit the space, because here is, of course, a intimate space, and why not choose some repertoire which suits that. So, I think Colleen's going to play 2 of these Songs Without Words from the Opus 53 book, and I'll leave it to her. Here's Colleen Lee. Thank you. And now on to some more Mendelssohn. This is a work for two clarinets and piano, so very unusual. Actually, Mendelssohn and the clarinet, that is in itself not something you think about much. You think of Mozart and the clarinet, or Spohr and the clarinet, or Weber and the clarinet. So, Johnny is back with us, Johnny Fong, his principal clarinet with us in the Hong Kong Sinfonietta. You know this piece a lot better than me. I mean, when I think about Mendelssohn and the clarinet, I think of some of the beautiful either clarinet solos or that beautiful clarinet sort of duo at the end of the Hebrides overture, for example. You think of those moments, but there's two works for two clarinets and piano, is that right?
Yes, originally it's written for two clarinet, but one clarinet and one basset horn. So basset horn is actually a bigger clarinet in
F. Of course, which Mozart used.
Yes, so Mendelssohn wrote this piece in 1832 for number one.
So he was very young.
So but now today we are going to play number two, which is written the year after that.
Ah, I see. So these are kind of very important works from the early 19th century.
Especially for the basset horn.
Yeah.
Not much composer composed for basset horn.
Yeah, sure. And did Mendelssohn, what's the word, sanction, permit two clarinets? Or he just basically for clarinet and basset horn?
And for clarinet and basset horn. But someone just rearranged it for two clarinets.
I see. And what about the work? Is it in one movement or more?
More or less, like one movement, but we have three sessions. The presto session at the beginning, and then a slower movement in between, and the last movement.
Great.
So three movements.
Yeah. Oh, fantastic. And who will be joining you on stage here at Wontonmeen?
Yeah, okay. Of course, my colleague Chiu-yuan on the second clarinet, and Jacqueline on the piano.
Great, I'll leave you to it.
Okay, thank
Thanks,
you.
Johnny.
好，差啲兩位嚟緊嘅時候咧，咁我都講少少啫。樂曲嘅背景啦，咁咧其實咧個樂曲咧同我哋今日喺呢個雲吞麵嘅地方表演都有啲關係嘅喎。咁你可能覺得雲吞麵一個香港嘅地方同只德國嘅作品有咩關係咧？咁其實呢個歌嘅誕生咧就同雲吞有關啦。 曼德爾遜咧嗰陣時咧寫呢個咧係寫俾當時咧對好出名嘅父子，邦文父子嘅。咁樣咧，佢哋寫嘅時候咧，佢就同佢講：你寫嘅歌俾我啦，但係咧我就唔需要收你任何嘅報酬，你只要咧請我食翻一餐好好味嘅雲吞，咁就已經當係呢個歌嘅回報啦。好，咁我哋都應該準備好啦，咁我哋為大家送上呢個歌啦。 Thank you.